All right, guys, we got a lot of work today, a lot of stuff to cover.
Hey, Squiscar! Sorry, Charles. Squiscar, sorry about that book. Boy, but look at what I got today, guys. It's my defibrillator. I bought it off Sky Mall.
Why do you need that?
It's, to shock people. If they have a thing like a heart attack or if they're just sleeping. But I bought it because it's awesome. Murderface, help me work this thing.
Guys, I don't think you should be messing around with a defibrillator.
God, will you butt out, please? I mean, God, don't let this guy abuse you, Nathan. He's trying to control you, just like Squishar did to Chokey. No offense, Squishar. Now, what do you want me to do, Nathan?
Just stand there. Oh, and say, clear.
Oh, awesome, like the doctors do on TV.
Guys, come on, let's...
Clear!
Dude, that's pretty awesome.
Oh, man, that was pretty awesome. Who the f*** peed on me?
I think you're the culprit in this particular mystery.
How can I pee on myself when I'm right here?
Squiscar, you're scheduled to play the Guitarganza, which kicks off the annual Norwegian Ice Festival in Lillehammer, and you're going to need to do a lot of promotional interviews, so get...
The victims of these Duncan Hill's coffee natural gas coincidence explosions need your help. Even I had my legs blown off and several pieces of shrapnel.
All right, so you all know we're in the middle of building a hospital for the victims of this public relations disaster.
Oh, God, that's pandering.
Pandering?
Well, I don't see it as pandering. It's a hospital for horribly injured victims of these explosions.
Hey, that's not our fault. We didn't do that.
Well, they are your fans, and they have been badly injured, and some of them killed, trying to buy your collectible coffee cups. Maybe you could show a little compassion.
Compassion?
Oh, no. I got no sympathy for anyone. I got one of these darn summer colds. I mean, where's my benefit concert? Is there anything worse?
See, that's something you have compassion for, summer cold. You can relate to that. You can't relate to your arms being blown off. You can't.
Well, maybe being blown to bits is worse than a summer cold.
Oh, come
Mr.
on.
Mr. Robatos, when the juice comes so caring about stuffs, does it drunks or something?
No, I'm not drunk. I'm just trying to, repair your image.
Repair our image with health care.
That's
why we've got to spend our hard-earned money on medical stuffs for people we don't even know fans.
Be concerned with security. All right? Doing everything in my power to make
this... Which reminds me, I should take this time to let all of you know that I'm stepping down as band fire chief.
Oh, boy.
I will take this time right now to listen to reason should any of you reconsider this position that you forced me into.
No, thanks.
That's high voice.
Moving right along.
Hey, listen. Actually, I would like to get serious for a moment, okay, if I could?
Very well.
I think it would be in the band's best interest to hire a Buddhist yoga instructor guy, dude.
Yes, a second date.
Oh, really? What, because, you guys are interested in yoga or spiritual guidance?
No,
or...
because we...
Yes, we want spiritual things.
Is that really the reason?
Yep, right, guys?
I thought we...
I'm sorry, I don't understand. Why do you need this?
We'd like to be able to reach things a little bit better.
To reach things.
Yeah, reach things.
Yep. Conversation over.
Welcome all of you to the initiation of the Clock of Tears. These following weeks will be the most difficult weeks of your lives. Some of you will be maimed, most of you killed. For those of you who survive, go on to attain the sacred branding of the gear. But until then, you're all worthless scum. So, roll the video.
Hey, folks.
Gentlemen, you have been receiving death threats from some of your fans.
So they're gonna die?
No, Pickles, they're threatening to kill you.
That's a different thing.
Yes. Before the show, we should do a couple safety briefings. I've outlined a very specific...
Very well, then. Anything else?
Any new ideas for the death merch? I remember you all complaining that you're sick of the...
Guys, are you ready? This is it.
Here's the new merch.
This is Time Travel's face bag.
Time Travel face bag? Am I saying that right? Looks like you have some plastic bags. What are you doing?
We're traveling through time.
Yeah, you put your face bag on, they travel through time.
Dear God! You, boy in the street! What day is it?
It's Wednesday. It's Friday.
I must have traveled
through time itself.
We've figured out how to travel through time at the speed of regular time with plastic bags.
It's your technology. Now it's true, trying to perform in two places at once will put us in the red. And the only way to make it back will be a super concession double blowout. We need to create a scenario wherein we can sell as many death cones as humanly possible.
Death cones.
Icy and brutal.
Believe it or not, gentlemen, snow cones could very well save our asses. Snow cones and merch. Here's a fun little video that'll explain everything.
Hey, folks, it's me, Facebone,
What happened to the Facebones thing? Guys, I'm trying to work here. Can you please stop?
What? We're just trying to help you.
Go get your car!
Go away. The five of you are the cause of all of this. I want you out of my sight now. Go. Go.
But what about, I thought we were going to hang out.
Get out of here!
I'm done with the conversation now.
Sit back down.
I'm sat.
Yeah, he was just like staring at his shoes and old mumblings. I tried to cheer him up. Tim.
Oh, that poor little f***. This is delicious with this crap dip.
You know, Toki's kind of in a fragile state of mind right now. He could really use your support.
God, don't let him fool you. He's tough as nails.
Guys, come in. You don't think Toki's gonna freak out or anything, you know, like do something, you know, should we hide the guns?
Well, I wouldn't go that far. I think he's just a little sad.
What, you mean he's gonna kill himself?
No, I mean he may kill us.
He's the one to do that. He's a strange. I don't trust him. I
can that.
He's in the head. I don't trust him. And
hello?
Don't do that to me.
Gets to go to Norway now. Sees my dad die. Sees you.
See you later, Toki's. Have some great times.
Oh, yeah, and say hi to your dad from us. I mean, if he doesn't die before you get there. Well, you know, say hi to his corpse, I guess. You know, I don't know.
Yeah, no matter what happens, say hi.
You're all invited to come to Norway's with me and, you know, just be pals.
Oh, that would be great. But, you know, we gotta do the record.
Oh, the album can work.
Yeah, it's gonna be twice as hard without you, so.
I understand.
Well, since you can't go to Norway because you gotta work on the album, just work on that album. Come on, guys. In the recording room. Chop, chop. Recording room. Come on. Come on. Every one of you. Come on. Chop, chop. Let's go. Recording room. Let's go. Recording room. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Let's get it moving.
You know something? You got the hearts of ice.
Yeah, you have a heart of ice.
How am we supposed to record when our brothers suffer so badly?
He doesn't get it.
Once again, if you're here, you're working on the record.
Hey, I'm gonna go support Toki. I can't work on the album. I'm not cruel.
No. Damn it, we should all go.
Firecracker.
Who let me just play bass and drink beer and smoke dope because I told him I'd cut his eyes out if he didn't let me graduate.
Nathan, I have your test results.
Oh, you open it. I can't stand the pressure.
Let's see here. Okay. It's a zero. No questions were answered.
Oh, damn. Seriously?
How could you have not known that?
Do you think you're better than me?
I took the liberty of writing your Harvard commencement speech.
Thanks.
Is my band out there and you're sober?
Well, Pickles, I hate to tell you, but you don't actually own the name Snakes and Barrels.
Why not? How did you let that happen?
Well, the band existed before you got there, and I didn't represent you then.
Well,
I assure you, it wouldn't
man.
Have happened had
They're
I
sober.
Represented you. Yes, I am. Could you please stop breaking my good lamps? Break those. They're from IKEA.
What, these ones?
Yeah.
You really get a lot of leaves in here.
Well, lighting is important. It creates a nice atmosphere.
Well, the whole thing that gets me is that they got a new singer. Like, who the f*** is that dildo? He's like a cheap, crappy knockoff, you know? And he changed him. It's like those guys are brainwashed. If I could just talk to him.
Well, you can't, Pickles. You see, they have a restraining order against you.
A restraining order? Sneaky, sober sucker.
Can we get some more lamps in here, please? The cheap ones, thank you.
Yeah. Hey, who am's breaking some of this lamps?
Just him, he is.
I want to break some.
They're bringing in more.
Hey,
Toki, they're bringing in more.
Hey, all this Snakes and Barrels got me thinking that I got some legal questions about my side band, you know, Planet Piss.
Do you think it can wait? I mean, we're in the middle of a meeting here.
What are you meeting about, lamps?
His name is Mel Ward Fjordslaw, and now he's working for Death Clock.
The very act of hiring another managerial figure could set off an internal fire that could manifest itself by stepping on toes.
A new managerial member could easily redirect the power in any way he sees fit.
This is Nelbert. He's gonna be helping us with the business so we can learn the business.
How do you do? Look, the health inspector's here to survey the Clocketeer's quarters. Odd, you may as well join them. And you, Melmer, show them how to fill out a status report of what we need fixed down there.
Sir?
What? Over here, sorry. Give me one.
Oh, me too!
Yeah, give him one.
Now take back your stupid lens!
Excuse me, we have been talking, and you know,
we want to know who owns the name Death Clock.
Guys, I'm in a meeting right now. If you don't mind, I'd like you to come
back. What are you meeting about, lambs?
Well, partially, but you just hang on.
How comes we ain't invited to the lambs meetings? Huh? See? This always happens. We get excluded.
Well, it's not really a lamb meeting, Squizgar, and if it were, I'd invite
See,
you.
See, that's okay? All I want to know.
Hey, who owns the name Deathclaw?
Yeah!
Well, guys, you should know this one. It's very easy.
Yous own it?
You guys do. The five of you own the name of your band.
Well, that's good.
Oh, thank
Finally,
God.
Something in our favor.
When were you going to tell us that?
You know what? Fish, all right? I'm pissed off. Sober and restraining order. I could attack you to those guys.
Because I'd advise against it. Don't go over there.
I'm going. Where are they now?
Humans, the TV shows?
No, no,
it's
no.
In the other
no,
rooms.
Snakes and barrels. Where are they now? Where are they? No.
Oh,
no,
where are they
actually.
Now? No. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's in the other room. That's a TV show.
Yeah, well, they know now.
Yeah,
they're on the TV.
No, we're to be in Snakes and Barrels
like, where
now.
Where do they film?
Channel,
where
channel
they
42.
Because I try not to watch a lot of TV,
they
so I don't really
know.
You
know, I want to know what he actually is. No, I'm saying that he actually wants to take it.
I
want to
know
what he
is. Stop.
They're in L.A. So, this is what you guys have been up to, huh? No answer? Getting back to your roots been good? Nathan?
Yes! It's been really good!
You guys, doing okay with no money or accommodations?
We've been fine! God!
Well, you don't sound fine. You sound, agitated, hungry, miserable. Anyway, the reason I'm here is that I caught wind that Thunder Horse is doing a health benefit. You guys realize that tonight is your, Chefs Around the World taste test party.
But we have an obligation, and Thunder Horse doesn't back down on obligations. Not like some other bands.
Well, I, brought you guys some, Kobe beef foie gras burgers.
No! We don't eat that fancy expensive stuff anymore. We're getting in touch with our roots!
All right, then. Well, you guys know how to get in touch with me, goodbye.
You're doing business with you and Death Clock, Charles.
Well, Roy, the way this band's been doing, I think we'll all become very wealthy. It's all quite metal. What's that sound? Huh?
Hey, where's all the f***ing slack?
Dad! Your stupid horse secretary told me that you weren't to be bothered. I told her to go f*** herself, and then I slapped her. Now I need some money, now!
Sorry, gentlemen. This is my son, Damien. Damien? This is a private meeting. You should be back at Recording Industry College.
That's stupid shit. I'll be running this place anyway since you don't know what the f*** you're doing. Look, you'll just let anybody in here. Look at this long-haired monkey. What kind of music do you play?
Death metal.
You mother...
Maybe it's best we all cool down, huh?
You'll be sorry for that, you son of a bitch! I'll never f***ing forget you did this!
Sorry, again.
Mm-hmm. What do I tell you guys before every meeting?
Try not to punch people.
Try not to punch people. That's correct.
What do you expect from us? These meetings are so boring. We don't care about them.
Well, you should care, William. Let me just say this to everybody. Pay attention to this contractual stuff, because, what if I'm not around in the future? 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 What if I'm not around in the future?
End of day.